Hello everybody, it's the last day of November in 2020. Hope you've all been well throughout the year. I know it's been one hell of a year, and I know you're probably all sick and tired of hearing about it from every YouTuber on the planet, but it is what it is, and well, I'm going to reserve comment for probably another video, but anyhow, like I said, hope you're all doing well. Tonight, we're going to do a bit of a unboxing here with this fine piece of equipment. And, yeah. I already took a razor blade to this. First, let's look at the side here, because it gives us our Chinesium information. And there you have it right there, folks. Craig Electronics. The brand name is Magnavox. It's definitely not Italian, so it's not fragile, but it is fragile. And yeah, for those of you who remember Craig Electronics, that was the name that was very prolific here in North America back in the late 60s, 1970s, with E-track tape players and car stereos and whatnot. And I'm pretty sure it's just one of a number of American names that the Chinesium conglomerates have acquired. Anyway, Craig Electronics, the brand is Magnavox, clearly another indicator of this item's country of origin. Magnavox, of course, no longer the mighty Magnavox of Fort Wayne, Indiana. So, let's open it up and see what we got. Ooh. They even used the 80s vintage logo. Stereo suitcase turntable system. You folks can probably see where this is going. It's a turntable with a radio. I didn't know that. Audio out, and of course the ever important Bluetooth, in case you want to listen to something that would be completely wasted on this particular unit. So let's see if we can get it out of the box, open her up, and enjoy the newness of it all. Yes. Okay, we're back here with you, and let's open her up. See what's inside. Now, I know guys like Radio TV Phononut and Shango 066 and a few others on YouTube who hate these Chinese imported turntables. I just want to put it out here right now that this particular unit was $100, but it wasn't. I actually found it online. I don't remember where, and I don't care to even promote it, but I found it online for $40 shipped. So you gotta figure this thing cost at least $15-$20 to ship it. So I paid next to nothing for this little gadget, which I basically only picked up to be a background piece. Here's the plastic bag accoutrements. And, yeah. Let's That's the legs. Apparently this thing stands up. And there's some more legs, I guess. I guess these are two-piece. And a power cord. I don't know how long these have been around on the market. I have no idea. I don't buy this stuff. But I was kind of looking for something to sort of sit in the background of another set for video. And I thought this looked pretty cool. Especially with these kind of buttons on it. I'll say this, the controls don't feel bad. They don't have that cheesy Chinese feeling about them. Oh yeah, here we go. Now we're getting into the meat of it here. Wonderful, highly efficient polystyrene platter that you can see must be belt driven because it doesn't want to spin. Quality Pickering cartridge, I assume. Well, at least they tied down the tone arm for shipping. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, let's get it up on its feet and get it powered up and see what it can do. Okay, we got the feet, or the legs on, rather. And these are just plastic, two-piece, kind of a twist-lock design. It is what it is. Being a briefcase-style or suitcase-style turntable, I would have thought that it meant a certain degree of portability, but as you can see, the legs are permanently attached. So you have to make a decision. If you want a portable unit, don't put the legs on it. They each attach with four self-tapping wood screws, and don't use a drill driver on it. You will strip it out. Let's look at the controls real quick. Here you have an auxiliary input stereo 1/8 headphone jack. They do supply the cable for the auxiliary. We got our function switch here, FM, Bluetooth, auxiliary, and of course phono. In the middle is our FM tuner. North American scale 87 to 108 megahertz, and of course volume and on off switch. Let's look at the back. Okay, around back we have our power in connector right here. It comes with a 12 volt wall wart. RCA line outs, piece of wire for your FM antenna. This one was manufactured in November of 2018, so this is already 2 years old. probably uninstalled stock. And the Bluetooth version is 4.1, for those of you wondering. And for those of you also wondering, since I got bagged on a couple of my earlier Chinese radio reviews, this really isn't meant to be a review. And if you're looking for me to kind of tear this all apart and take a look at the guts, I'm not going to do that. Not for what I paid for this thing. There's a million Crosley turntable videos on YouTube if you want to see what the guts of one of these is, because pretty much all of this here is the same across the whole thing. So yeah. Oh, and by the way, we got our cartridge here. It was shipped with a little guard on it. It actually came with a spare stylus. So that's cool. And here's your 45 adapter. Can't forget that. And speaking of 45s, we got some. So we're going to get this whole thing powered up, and we'll be severely disappointed together. Hang on. Okay, let's turn it on and see how it sounds. This is the FM radio.
The official station of the North Pole.
Christmas Music Station, 98.3 TRY.
I want to hear from ESPN. I want to hear from all of them.
XXLMag.com again. Keyword countdown. Now he kicked off the count.
I am the time. Found in a home and pigeon.
Because of the narrative around COVID-19. It's sick.
Yard punt and a beauty, and more words exchanged across the way with these two teams. We're late in the first quarter with no score. And time to check the schedule. The game's coming up on
Week 1.
It's sponsored by Hulu Plus.
All right. The FM radio isn't too bad in this thing. Reception's actually pretty decent.
Next Monday night, we will be in Arizona. Now,
but I can write a song.
And 106.1 is a member-supported service, and your contribution matters. Plus, your donation is tax-deductible.
And it's fairly loud, too. And it doesn't sound offensive. Granted, it's not a big 6x9 speaker like you're going to find in a classroom record player, but I've heard worse. We'll put it that way. This is much louder than I expected it to be.
While these presentations...
But again, that's on the FM radio. Let's try Bluetooth here. I paired something up with it a few minutes ago. Let's see if it held. Alright. Got to go to Moto here. And press the play button.
To hear about our new CD, please visit pulseplanet.com. Pulse of the Planet is made possible by the National Science Foundation. I'm Jim Metzner.
A new crash is stirring up trouble on the 5 in Mission Viejo, helping you around it and more in 2 minutes. We'll also be updating a problem on the 91 in Anaheim. It's a crash there. It's 5:53.
People leaving L.A. and Orange County, those areas, for the Inland Empire, even though rents are dropping closer to the coast and rising in the IE.
That may be the way prices are moving, but it's still a lot cheaper in the...
All right, loud enough. Typical Bluetooth audio. And
people are moving into the more affordable Riverside area and also getting a little additional space so that they're able to work from home.
Well, that's because nobody has, you know, $500,000 sitting in their back pocket to buy a crappy house in the LA Basin.
That drive, you can sacrifice a little bit of.
So I can totally agree with that. Plus, people want to get away from this COVID crap and all the lockdowns and stuff. And yeah, we've had that influx from New York City and Long Island up here enough to actually affect our local elections and turn a couple of our congressional districts blue.
But at least here, the Rams and Chargers.
So that doesn't sound too bad. I don't have anything really to put into audio. You can tell that blue light comes on for Bluetooth, red light comes on for auxiliary, and phono. Should we put a record on? Let's see here. First of all, if you're going to put a record on this thing, I would not put your unplayed first pressing of Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon on here. That is not a piece of vinyl that you want to be sacrificing to this little thing. I don't know if I can get the camera won't even have any part of it. There it goes. Little $5 needle. So, you know, if you've got, you know, some junky sort of thrift store records or something, I think that would be more appropriate to playing on a record player like this. So let's see what we got here. We'll just pull some stuff out at random. And see what we got here. Because I'm not really worried too much about copyright. Because I don't monetize my videos. So, see if we can find something that people would know. Yeah, we do have a lot of Stevie Wonder. Here we go. This is one that we know. And okay, selectors on phono, I'm assuming. The speed selector. Ooh, automatic start. Honestly, I expected a single channel amplifier, but this is stereo on all modes.
Very superstitious.
day, definitely stereo. The camera's microphone is not going to do this any justice, but it's certainly not going to compress the audio that much more than it already is to begin with. I mean, this really does sound on par with a very low-cost portable record player from the 60s or the 70s. It's not offensive, but again, it's a novelty. It's not a serious thing. This is, you know, if you had an elderly person in a nursing home, they might appreciate this. Something simple, something they can pack away. For your audiophiles out there, the guys with the Technics 1200s and whatnot, no. You can't compare the two. So let's try an LP, see how that sounds. You know what? I'm not gonna pick this apart. It reminds me of a old RCA record player that I had in the mid 70s. That was basically in a little plastic cabinet. It was mono only with a little 3x5 speaker. And only a speed switch and an on-off volume switch. And this record player here just really reminds me of that. It sounds almost identical to it. The speed is actually pretty good on this too. I don't have a revolution meter, an RPM meter on my phone to test it, but I can tell just by ear, because I mean, I play vinyl every week. The speed is pretty much on. It might be just a little fast, like 46 RPM or 34 RPM, something like that. It's not terrible. It's very listenable. Again, for someone who's stuck in a retirement home or a nursing home, or if you just want the display piece, I mean, it does have that kind of sort of vintage-y guitar amp sort of look to it, and I mean, it does Bluetooth and it does FM radio. It's got that quasi electronic chip based tuner in it. First to call
for some pretty good things about me.
But it's not terrible. It actually has pretty good sensitivity. So it's picking up a lot of low power stuff around here.
Yeah.
So there it is, your Magnavox MD-708 suitcase-style record player here on North River TV. You know what? I'm gonna make people mad, and I'm going to give it a thumbs up. But I'm also going to put this disclaimer on it. I bet you will not probably find a nicer unit as this one. Even the fit and finish is good on it. The only disappointment is the legs are permanently installed, so it's really not that portable. There's no carry handle, and there's nowhere to store the power cord. Outside of that, again, not terrible, but also not serious hi-fi equipment. That's all. I hope you all are doing good. And we're going to have a few more videos over the course of the winter time as we get certain projects taken care of. So until we see each other again, be well, and keep fighting for the old republic.